ask you also to be with the people that are about to see you, Lord, and let us listen to every word that is being sung, Lord. It is a wonderful song, and we want to thank you for saving us, Lord. Lord, we love you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
He stood beside the gates of heaven, waiting to go in. And he wondered how this holy place could take a man like him. With shouts of great rejoicing and with music, then they came. Of the angels standing by him, he asked what could be their name. These are the company of prophets, the goodly fellowship of souls, who spake God's word with faith and boldness, who blessed the poor and made the wounded whole.
Oh, he fell upon his knees and cried, I am not one of these. He waited till another band of shining ones drew nigh. They entered into heaven with a hallelujah cry. He asked again, who are these? Can you tell me whence they came? He seemed to see the answer in a burning tongue of flame.
These are the company of martyrs, the mighty fellowship of saints, who knew our Lord and walked beside him, who ran the holy race and did not faint.
Oh, he fell upon his knees and cried, I am not one of these.
Then suddenly a multitude was heard from far away. Their voices rang with songs of joy, like children at their play.
He saw Rahab, David,
Mary Magdalene, and Paul.
And the thief who died by Jesus was the one who led them all.
Angels.
These are the sinners saved by grace,
the host
who called upon the Savior,
washed in blood and justified by faith. And oh, he leaped up from his knees. I can go in with ease. I can go in. Yes, I can go in. I'm washed in the blood, everlasting life to win. I can rejoice. I can lift up my voice. I can sing.
can go in. I can rejoice.
I am redeemed.
I can lift up my voice. I can sing. I can go
better than that. I don't see how you stay in your seat after that one. If you're saved by grace and you know it. You don't have to be a preacher. You don't have to be a martyr. You don't have to be anybody. Just an old sinner that comes to Jesus. Hello. I've come too far to quit. You have come too far to quit. What do you do when you're a fighter but the fight comes at the wrong time? I want to talk to people who are fighting tired. Fighting tired. If you've got a ministry for any length of time and you're doing anything for God, you're tired. You should go home tired on a Sunday, okay? On a Sunday evening, after Sunday evening service, you should go home and just want to go to bed. If the Cowboys aren't on or if the Longhorns aren't, I'll go straight to sleep. Hello? I'm talking to somebody, and they said, "Preacher, I need a break. I need to get away." He was right, because he was still in the fight, okay? But he was fighting tired. I told him, I said, "You're fighting tired with me and a bunch of other people, okay, that are in the fight." And he's got a minister, and he's doing something for God, and he's got a job here at the church, okay? And I said, "You're fighting tired. That's what everybody in the Bible that followed God, okay, they did. They fought tired." I don't know about you, but I am swinging tired. You ever see a boxer, it's a round 15, and they're like, "Yeah, ew," they're like a drunk, but they're still swinging. They're getting punched, but they're still. You ever see those UFC fighters? That happens to them a lot, man. They get hit on the chin, no gloves hardly. They get hit, but they're still swinging. They don't give up. They're tough. They're fighting tired. Don't give up the fight. Amen. You will hate yourself for it, I promise you. Stay in there. If you're not doing anything, get busy. We need ushers. We need people to clean the church. We need soul winners on bus routes. We need people working in the nursery. We need people working in the baptistries. We need people cleaning. We need bus drivers. We need a lot of workers. They're tired. Yes, I'd rather stay home on Saturday. Yes, I'd rather let someone else do the preaching, the tithing, and the giving. Yes, I'd rather take my wife out of the ministry and let her stay home. Okay, but that'll never happen even if I wanted it to. I'd rather back off the hard preaching and get a bigger crowd or whatever it is. Okay, I'd like to fall in with the contemporary crowd and go home and get my paycheck, never go soul winning, never do anything else, never tell the truth, amen. Get a bunch of yuppies in here. And sit still, yuppies. Sit still. You could be a saved yuppie. Amen. Praise the Lord. Number one, you ready? Because I want to go to Burger King and get the double Whopper with cheese with a Dr. Pepper and fries. Dallas don't play till 3:30. Oh, they play at 3:30. There's no evening service, okay? No, you need a break because you're fighting tired. So we'll just, no, I'm just kidding. You better come. Come too far to quit. Come too far to quit. Oh, I got to turn it on. Ready? Fight because Jesus has got a whole bunch invested in us. Amen. It's not that you got a bunch invested in Jesus. It's that he's got a lot invested in you. Amen. And you sit there and do nothing for God? Are you kidding me? Yeah, he's got a lot invested. Hello? I'll tell you what he's got a lot invested. For you are bought with a price, therefore glorify God in your body and your spirit, which are God's. You are bought with a price. You are bought with the precious blood of Jesus Christ. You sit there with that scowl because I told you the truth that you're lazy, you're a quitter. Well, you could say it right back to me the first day I quit, but I wouldn't hold your breath. I talked to a guy here in the church who's visiting. He works on vaccines. And I said, is the plague coming again? He said, oh, yeah. His job is to get all this stuff ready. You think we're going to shut the church down? Don't hold your breath. We didn't shut a day down the first time. We're not shutting a day down the second. We're going to follow God's laws above man's laws, whether it, I don't care if it gets everybody mad, it gets your mother mad, it hair-lips every dog in town. We're going to do what God says to do, and they'll leave the abortion clinics open, they'll leave the liquor stores open, and they'll try to shut the church of God. Good luck, buddy. Throw me in jail. I don't give a flip. Julie said they got good sandwiches in prison. Bring me cigars. Oh, they don't let you smoke, do they? He volunteered his son. He gave his son for a sacrifice so I could live with him forever. I would say he invested in us. He invested his reputation in you and I. How do you represent him? How do you represent him? You live like the devil when you leave church. You cuss. You drink. You smoke. You dip. What do you do when you leave? How do you represent the one who died for you? He invested his reputation. I was in Walmart. I don't know. It was a long time ago. And this, you know, how they give out food. And this guy had a thing on his thing with the picture of the Pope on it. And he was giving out the food. And I just happened, this guy, a bummer day for him. Because I just happened to say, man, I want a sausage, okay? But I saw that Pope thing. It said, I'm so glad. I'm Polish and my Pope is Polish. And I said, I walked up to him and I said, yeah, I'll take one. I said, by the way, are you proud of your Pope? He said, yeah, he's the vicar of Christ. I just walked away, didn't say nothing. You believe that? No, because I'm bought with a price. No, because the Bible says in Ephesians 5:11, take no part in the unfaithful works of darkness, but instead expose them. Expose them. I took his little sausage and pretzel and said, you know who the Pope is? Who is he? I said, he's the vicar of hell. That's what he is. And it was on. It was on. Hey, don't let somebody preach you a false gospel. You got to say something. Yeah, that poor guy. They told him, look, all you got to do is put a little pretzel in a sausage and handed out to people. He didn't realize that Keith the Baptist with an attitude was coming to his table. Don't let him get away with the lies, false prophets. And I gave him a track. I said, look, you don't have to follow what the Pope says. You can get saved and go to heaven. You can follow what Jesus says. Get away from my table. So I grabbed the hot grease and I threw it in his face. And he was, yeah! God's got too much invested in you and me not to say anything, not to do anything. Who do you think you are? Who do you think you are? Never to stand up for God. You don't have to get in arguments all the time. I don't. Sometimes I pass them by too. I just don't feel like arguing. I don't feel like I'm ashamed. I don't feel like giving a gospel. I'm there too, man. But a lot of times the Holy Spirit say, how can you get up and preach and you let this go and not say anything? I said, great, Lord. It's my day off, and here you go making me preach. We don't have no day off. We ought to fight because we are hungry. Amen. Don't stop fighting. Don't quit. Don't be a quitter. Nobody likes a quitter. Sit down, David. Sit down and quit walking around. Thank you. God bless you. Love you. Give me a kiss. Because I'm hungry, man. I'm still preaching. I'm still soul winning. I'm still telling the truth. Why? Because I'm hungry. Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled. Are you hungry? Are you hungry? Then you'll show up Saturday. You'll show up one of these days. You'll pass out track. You'll preach. You'll give a track out at work. Get that. We got all kinds of gospel tracks. I'm hungry to get my prayers answered, Brother Ray. I'm hungry to see marriages work. I'm hungry to keep people out of hell. I'm hungry to get more kids and people on bus routes. I'm hungry to see more people saved and baptized. I'm still hungry. That's why I fight. Too many of you people on diets. Get busy for God. Thank you. When we get to heaven, there won't be no dieting. Somebody shout amen. I'm telling you, this thing, I haven't buttoned this thing in 3 years. And there won't be any ties in heaven either, or suits. I'm fighting hungry. I'm out of breath. But I'm in too deep in this Jesus thing. I'm out in the deep. I jumped out in the deep years ago. And some of you got saved years ago, and you're still on the beach flopping around playing games. You need to jump off the end of the pier for God where you can't touch bottom and you know only Jesus is holding your marriage together. Only Jesus is holding your church together. Only Jesus is holding your health together. Only Jesus is holding your mind together from going crazy. I've been in the battle for 47 years now. Older than most of you. I can start to see foothills of glory. I can start to see, hey, is that a porch light on a mansion? I'm getting close. Let us cross over and rest in the shade of the trees on the other side, the Bible says. Stonewall Jackson, when he died, a great general, he said, let me cross over. He quoted that verse, let me cross over the Jordan and rest under the shadow. He's ready to go to heaven. Many other people said that too. And then he breathed his last breath. I am bound for the promised land. I am bound for the promised land. Oh, who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. I am bound for the promised land. I am bound for the promise. You can do what you want to do. But who will come and go with me? I am bound for the promised land. Somebody shout amen. Amen. I'm fighting tired. I'm at war. Not only with my enemies, I'm in war with myself. That's the biggest battle, having a right spirit, having a right attitude. When all the world and church people and everybody at work, at school, your wife, your husband, your kids, everybody's trying to break your heart. Everybody's trying to get you derailed to quit. They're trying to get you to quit because they've quit and they want to feel more comfortable, so you'll join them. You'll regret it. I've got too much invested, and Jesus has too much invested in me. If you're serving God up close, and it's up close and personal, this thing. You get up close and personal when you witness and when you're serving God. The fight is a good fight, okay? I don't care if you're in Walmart, behind the pulpit, streets and apartments and houses of San Antonio, prisons where we go and witness to people, thrift stores. Job, school, bus routes. I got 1,000 stories I could tell you. War stories. Up close and personal with people. Yeah. Because I want to go to Whataburger, I'm not going to tell them, okay? The fighting is up close and personal now. They're telling you that it's a lie, what you're seeing with your own eyes. Our government is, they're liars. They're liars, and we're putting up with it. They're telling you what is good is bad, and what is good is evil, and what evil is good, and they want you to swallow the slop. The fighting's up close and personal now. Go out there and witness. Witness somebody at work and school. You'll see how personal it is. But then somebody is looking. Somebody's ready. God has a purpose for you. It's to win somebody to Christ. Why would he leave you back here if you're saved? Why would he leave you down here? Because you're so good looking and you better look in a mirror. He left you here because you have someone he wants to be with him in heaven forever. He's going to use you to do it. Jesus is not going to come down and knock on the door. It's your job. It's my job. Go you therefore in all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. You can find a creature everywhere. They're throwing gay marriage in your face. No Bible, no prayer in schools in your face. Abortion at command. Abortion when the baby's born, just let it sit there and die. And you're supposed to accept that. And you vote for a Democrat? I've never heard of a Republican who believes in abortion. I'm sure there are. And I'm not saying you're evil if you're Democrat or Republican. They're all a bunch of liars. You got to lie at some time or another to be elected to anything. I didn't get enough amens. They're a bunch of liars. There's a bunch of snakes and vipers in D.C., it's not their fault. Snakes and vipers, that's how they're born. We voted them in and we put up with it. It's my people who are called by my name. That's what God said. If you will humble yourself and pray. Not petition Washington and get you no abortion kills on a sign. Go out there and win some woman who's for abortion to Christ. She won't be for abortion very long. Am I getting through to you? Amen. A U.S. ambassador just recently was dragged and murdered from his home, and we put up with it. We pulled out of our knucklehead president, pulled out. Knucklehead, I said. That's a good name for him. I could think of Satan himself. He's just a pawn anyway. And don't come up to me and say you shouldn't say, oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, you should call out evil, the Bible says. I have all respect for the office. Oh, yeah. But, boy, we put a knucklehead in there this time. You voted for him, too. So if you voted for him, that means you're okay for a woman having a baby, putting the baby in the table and just letting it die from starvation or cold. Because that's what they're for. Let's just tell it like it is. We're not in Washington right now. Hello? Amen. Right in your face, he pulled out of Afghanistan and left billions and billions and billions of our supplies and equipment there when he could have waited and brought it all home. He left 13 people there in the middle, and some of them were killed by terror. I'm talking about Marines. I'm talking about U.S. Army. I'm talking about Navy. I'm talking about all of them were murdered because our stupid president pulled out because of politics. And left an airbase that we should have kept right next to China, but we just gave it away. Right in our face. And we sit there. Yuck. Put me in the White House. Give me 3 days. I'll fire everybody. Amen. I'm tired, but I'm still swinging, aren't you? Amen. Preachers preaching from pulpits with earrings, committing adultery and back in the pulpit 2 months later. Queers and lesbian preachers, lesbian and queer priests lady priest out in the open. If you say that's wrong, me preaching that, you're wicked as they are.
Amen.
You have no idea what righteousness is. You have no idea what a holy Bible is. You have no idea what a holy Jesus is.
Amen.
Wicked of the devil and straight out of hell, man.
Amen.
I was visiting Tony when he was sick. Some of you were with me when he was real sick in the hospital. I was walking back with Joseph, I think. And here comes this female priest walking towards me. Over there by SeaWorld, that hospital over there. Female priest in all the black and the little collar. I said, "Hi, how are you?" She says, "Good, how are you?" I said, can I ask you a question? She says, "Well, sure, my friend." I said, "Are you a pastor?" She says, "Well, I sure am." I said, "Do you know what the Bible says about being a pastor?" "Well, it says many things." I said, "Well, do you realize that one verse in the Bible says a pastor should be the husband of one wife?"
Amen.
So how are you a husband of one wife?
Amen.
You know what she said? She looked at me and said, "Is that right? I'm going to have to check that out." Seems like to me you would have checked that out before you became a priest.
Amen.
Seems like to me you would have known your Bible before you ever tried to represent Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because when you're representing Jesus, you're representing the Word of God. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. I know you're bored with this preaching because you're not doing nothing. But you can get right with God and start doing something. Find you a church. Okay, that you like the preacher, that you like the color of carpet, and you get busy for God.
Right.
I'm in too deep to let the devil have it. I'm fighting for the last soul. I want to see the last person put in the lifeboat, and then the rapture happen. If I could preach at my own funeral, I would. Maybe I'll tape a message and play it at my funeral. And I'm dead, you still have to listen to me. Number three, we got to hurry. We got to hurry. Everybody is tired, but let's fight anyway. Everybody's tired, but let's fight anyway. You brethren, be not weary in well-doing. You're doing what's right. You're coming to church. You're tithing. You're witnessing. You're reading your Bible. You're walking with God. Don't get tired doing the right thing. You're fighting without a job. You just lost your job, but you're still fighting anyway. You're fighting without a spouse, but you're still fighting anyway. Somebody help me now. You're fighting without a wife or a husband, but you're fighting anyway. You're fighting without any money, but you're fighting anyway. You're fighting when you lost your health, but you're still fighting anyway. You're fighting without the support of your family. They think you're a cult member, but you're fighting anyway. They won't think you're a cult member when the rapture happens and they're left behind.
Amen.
You're fighting with your kids who are lost and they're out in the world, but you're fighting anyway. You're fighting with a broken heart, but you're fighting anyway. You're fighting lonely, but you're fighting anyway. God bless you. You're fighting older and you're older and you find yourself, it's harder to get out of bed now, but you're fighting anyway. You find somebody who looks like they're in the fight and you encourage them to keep fighting. Number four, I got 7 minutes. You ready? Keep fighting for what Jesus has given you. Has Jesus given you anything? Do I have to remind you he gave you your last breath when you said amen? Keep fighting for what he has given you. Therefore, seeing we have this ministry, as we have received mercy, we faint not. We faint not. Hey, you know who gave you your bus route? Jesus. You know who gave you your ministry? You know who put you as an usher? Jesus did. You know who put me in this pulpit? Jesus did. He's given me a ministry. I'm not going to quit on him. You people who clean the church, who cut the grass, and care about what the church looks like, he's given you that ministry. Don't take it lightly and just quit. You know why? Because the Bible says men ought to always pray and not to faint. Not to faint. Don't quit. Don't quit on our Savior. Keep fighting and praying for your kids and family and marriage. You say, but preacher, God has not answered my prayer. You know what you're really saying when you say that? God has not answered my prayer. You're saying, I haven't gotten from God what I want yet. Because the Bible says, blessed be God who never ignores my prayers and always gives me mercy, the Bible says. Always answers your prayer. You just didn't get your Mercedes. You just didn't get the job you wanted. God has commanded us to pray, not to get whatever we want. Men ought always to pray, not to faint. Keep fighting for what God has given you. Keep. I'm just trying to encourage you, man. Tell a joke or two. Let you laugh. Okay, but then tell you the truth. And get out of here and go do something for God, man. Time is short. Life is too long to live it without doing something for Jesus Christ. That is, if you're saved. If you're not saved, you can get saved right after this message. Don't give up on those kids. Don't give up on me. Don't give up on your marriage. Don't give up on the people at work. Don't give up on your kids who broke your heart. Don't do it. My kids have an attitude. They don't want to go to church. Don't give up on them. My wife has fasted at least one day a week for our children for 40 years. I don't know, 38 years. The oldest is 38. Every week. Every week. I think I married the right woman. Amen. Don't give up on your Sunday school class. Don't give up on your bus route. Number, whatever. People don't get tired doing nothing. It is the well-doing that gets us weary. If you're not in the fight, get in it. Amen. If you're not in the fight, get in it. Keep showing up, passing out flyers, working in the nursery, helping in the baptistry, going to the prison. These guys need help when they go to the prison. I know when it comes time to go, they're tired, they've worked all day and everything else. They want to go out there and be locked up with a bunch of prisoners when it's 110 degrees. But they need the gospel too. You got too much invested. I'm in too deep. You're in too deep serving Christ to quit now. Bus workers, I know you're hot. Bus drivers, I know you're hot. And you get little appreciation. You guys who fix things, Mark Zinmeister and other people fixing, we have a gas leak, okay? And he's got to pull that pipe out and fix it in the heat. You guys, don't get tired. I know you're tired, but don't quit. Keep doing something for God. It doesn't look good, and all hell is breaking loose in our country and the world, but keep swinging. Keep kicking. Keep scratching. Keep clawing, all right? If you're not in the fight, get in it, man. Get in it. But neither Titus, who was with me, being a Greek, was compelled to be circumcised, and that because of false brethren unaware brought in, who came privately to spy out our liberty which have in Christ Jesus, and they might bring us into bondage. Bondage. Even Paul and all of them were fighting these people coming in the church saying, hey, you must be circumcised too. Oh, you can get saved and you can get baptized, but you got to be circumcised like the Old Testament. No, 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 no. They fought the same fight we're fighting. Bunch of wolves come with sheep clothing. You've seen me. I've tossed them out physically. Bunch of wolves. Just keep fighting. Keep telling people the truth. We need bus workers. We need nursery workers. We need people to pass out flyers. We need people to clean the church. We need rest home help. We need bee service help. We need prison help, homeless help. We need help. We need help. Amen. Don't let your family and friends think that your Savior is not worth it. You've messed up. You've already told them how great Jesus is. Now they're going to watch you to the end of your life. You quit? Oh, I guess He's not worth living for, is he? You quit. Ooh. You need to take that dart out of your side, don't you? That hurts. It would hurt if I quit too. Fight the good fight of faith. Lay hold on eternal life, whereunto thou art also called and has professed a good profession before many witnesses. You've already told how great Jesus is to your mom and dad and to your aunt and uncle and to all your cousins and nephews. You've already told them you go to church. You've already told them how great Jesus is and I would never quit. You messed up, man. First of all, you messed up and got saved. You had no idea living for Christ was going to be like this. You actually had to do something. Go ahead and quit. You're so used to quitting. Quit your job. Quit soul winning. Quit tithing. Quit church. Quit doing right. But just in case you really love Jesus, stay in the fight. Just in case you really love Jesus, it's a good fight. And notice it's a good fight, the Bible says. You ever see a fight between two women? They scratch, they claw, they spit, they pull hair. It's a good fight. You ever see them? Don't quit. Don't quit fighting. Get in deep with God. If you're getting deep with God, it'll be hard to quit. If you're in deep with God, it'll be hard for you to quit because you've invested so much in it.
Amen.
The red light's on. That means I got to quit. Praise the Lord. Don't quit. I beg you, don't quit. For Christ's sake, don't quit. Please, let's bow our heads and close our eyes. Heads bowed, eyes closed. Nobody looking and gawking around at people. You should be in prayer. What's wrong with you? You should be down here at the altar. What's wrong with you? You're sitting there looking at people. What's that all about? It's everybody else except you. Everybody else is the problem except you. You get it right. You start doing something. Heads bowed, eyes closed. You say, preacher, I'm saved. I'm born again. I know I'm saved.